As you can tell, I'm a heck of my own mother. Because it was getting long and it was just driving me nuts. Because I don't mind having these ends grow during quarantine, but the fringe has always been a problem. But anyways, that's enough about me. Well, actually, no. Before I get on with what I had to do today on this vlog, I have some very good news for you all. My mum got tested for the third and final time and she's now come back negative and COVID-19 is gone. Both of us are negative and we're no longer to self-isolate from each other. So, I just had my first hug from her after months and months self-isolating. Oh, I never felt so good in my life. So that's my news for today. But on with the actual chase. What's going to happen today is I'm gonna let you all react with me to a video that I did with the Heathlands Film Project. This is about, well, funny enough, a game called Pandemic. What day was that? First. That must be Spiff's my video. Anyways, I'm gonna get down to it. Let you all see how much of a good job that I did on the voice. This is my voiceover for a Heathlands gaming review for the game Pandemic. Okay. Are you all ready? Here we go. Heathlands Gaming Reviews presents Pandemic. This game is for ages 8 and up. It takes up to 2 to 4 players and only takes around about 45 minutes to play.
That's me there, doing the voiceover, off and on camera.
You're all 4 diseases to win. 1, 2, 3, 4. Infections. Before gameplay starts, 9 cities are infected. Draw 3 city cards and put 3 cubes of the corresponding colour onto each city. Draw another 3 city cards and put 2 cubes of the corresponding colour onto each city. Draw further 3 city cards and put 1 cube of the corresponding colour onto each city. Infection cards are drawn from here.
One favorite shot ever.
48 infection cards, 1 for each city. Outbreaks. Avoid the outbreaks. Get to 8 outbreaks and you lose the game. You can have 3 disease cubes of the same colour on the same location. Any more cubes of that colour causes an outbreak. Outbreaks cause the disease to spread to all adjoining cities. Add 1 disease cube of the same colour to each adjoining city. If the adjoining city already has 3 cubes of that colour, this causes another outbreak. Cure markers. Move markers down when that colour disease is cured. Flip marker when a disease is eradicated. A disease is eradicated after the disease is cured and the disease cubes of that colour have been cleared from the board. You can only cure a disease if you're at a research station. The infection rate starts at 2. Move the infection rate marker 1 space each time an epidemic card is drawn. Epidemic cards are mixed in with the player cards and come out randomly when players are dealt cards after the action stage. There are 59 player cards that are made up of 48 city cards, 6 epidemic cards, and 5 event cards. 48 city cards. You need 5 city cards of the same colour to cure disease. Unless your roll card says otherwise, 5 event cards in the base game and more in the expansion. These are mixed in with the player cards. Choose your roll. There are 7 to choose from in the base game, plus more in the game expansions. Here are the 6 roll cards from the On the Brink expansion. Shuffle the cards and deal 1 to each player, or as we chose to do, deal 2 to each player and let them have a choice. Here's what our gaming group chose. Archivists, quarantine specialist, containment specialist, and a medic. Place your matching colour figures with the research station on the 290 to start the game. In the box, you also get 4 action cards explaining what counts as one action. Use our game board as we're about to have our first round. After your 4 actions, draw 2 cards from here. The player's rip rating of this game as follows: 7 out of 10 for fun factor, 7 out of 10 for complexity, and 10 out of 10 for replay value. Out of the 4 players who played this game, 3 would play again, all 4 enjoyed it, all 4 felt that they would need help to play the game again. Conclusion: this is a great game with lots of replay value, but for our members, they feel that they would always need a person to help run the game. This is Sarah Farmer for Heathen's Gaming Reviews.
So what do you guys think of that? That took me about 2 weeks to film and edit. It took me 2 weeks to get the entire thing together, but I had an assistant, it's not just me, that helped with the edit. I had my support worker, shout out to Mark, not the Mark that I really like, just Mark with a C, just to let you know. This took me about 2 weeks to film and finish in December 2019, and I feel a bit, I don't know whether I regret it or that I feel proud or that, maybe it's just a mix of emotions that now we have a pandemic going on, no vaccine. So, well, live in hope, guys, there will be a vaccine. Seeing that me and Mum have both tested negative, so that's good news. Is there any other notes I should say about that? Well, I can then end with this. If I don't know whether you can tell by the music and the way I talk, you can actually, if you listen carefully, you can actually, it sounds like I'm rapping. Just look out for that, because the way that go do something like that, and like that sort of beat, it sounds like I'm rapping. So that was Heathland's film group with their gaming reviews for the game Pandemic, and yours truly as your voiceover. So yeah, that's pretty much my update, news and reaction video for now. So see you guys pretty soon, hopefully tomorrow. But I might vlog tomorrow. Oh, and I'm gonna explain something tomorrow, but I need to get out and about and tell you guys first. So I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.